Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to Political Science class. Today we have two sessions. This is the first one. Okay, in the last session we had seen the relationship between India and the African countries, a relationship between India and the African countries soon after independence of India. Okay, so number of African countries also decolonized at that time. Okay, colonialism, we know that, right? What is colonialism? Ashish Bini, what is colonialism? Colonialism. Colonial government, colonies, an area,
independent, no,
dependent on what?
Some other countries.
Then tell me, what is the real meaning of the term colonialism? Sneha, can you hear me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Now tell me, what is that?
Developed countries.
So, what is that, Amal Raj?
So, what does the question be?
Colonialism.
Say, country being controlled by other.
Basically, European countries using their military power, their mighty army to control the other countries, basically in Asia and Africa. Clear? Most of the Asian and African countries, it was under the control of these European powers for several years. Maybe in centuries, we can say. European countries are the colonial ones. Clear or not? Clear? They are colonized number of countries with their army or a mighty navy, we can say like that. Okay, clear or not? And made those countries under their control for several centuries and looted the resources of those countries, right? Yes or no? So remember the term colonialism, colonies. Okay, India was a colony of Britain, right? Like that. Various countries in Asia and Africa, it was under the control of, or those countries were under the control of different European countries like Portugal, Spain, France, again, England. Clear? Understand? Dutch people. In India, almost all these people came and they made, trade relationship with India. The Dutch people, the Portuguese people, or the French people, and the English people, right? Clear or not? Okay, so that's what colonies or colonialism, that activity, okay, is termed as colonialism. Okay, controlling the less powerful countries with the use of arms, weapons, or military, okay. That is termed as colonialism. So, number of newly independent countries in Asia and Africa after the Second World War, they don't know what want to do. What want to do? Want to join with the US group or want to join with the USSR group? Okay, that is the time Nehru and a number of other leaders, they thought about NAM. Okay, non-alignment movement. Clear? Okay, so number of meetings, number of conferences, later number of countries they joined from Africa and Asia in the NAM, non-alignment movement. That's what we discussed in the last class. Okay, yet given its size, location and powerful potential, Nehru envisaged a major role for India in world affairs and especially in Asian affairs. Okay, clear or not? Okay, so our country is a large one, a vast country with various resources. Clear? And human capital, and a number of other strategical importance is there for the country called India. So Nehru came to know all these things there, and he started interfering in Asian affairs. Okay, his era was marked by the establishment of contact between India and other newly independent states in Asia and Africa. So he tried to create a contact, a good relationship with other countries in Asia and Africa. Clear? Jawaharlal Nehru tried to create good relationship with the African and Asian countries. Throughout in the years, 1940s and 1950s. Nehru had been an ardent advocate of Asian unity. Okay, he's a strong believer, or always he's speaking about or spoke about the importance of Asian unity. Clear? Under his leadership, India convened the Asian Relations Conference in March 1947. Underline. Okay, the same year that we got, that particularly we got independence. Okay. 5 months ahead of attending the independence, India made earnest efforts for the early realization of freedom of Indonesia. Okay. And Indian government, they helped the Indonesia to attain freedom, Indonesia. Okay. So from Dutch colonial regime, by convening the international conference in 1949. So Indonesia was under the control of Dutch colonial rule, and India supported Indonesia to gain independence. India was a strong supporter of the decolonization process. So India is against colonization and helped a number of countries to get independence. Okay. That process is known as a decolonization. Sorry. Okay. And India was the staunch supporter of the decolonization process and family apostolicism, especially apartheid in South Asia, South Africa, right? Apartheid. We discussed that it was a system that existed in South Africa. It's a racial discrimination on the basis of color, right? Yes or no? Apartheid. So underline that word, apartheid, important word for the summation, 1 mark. The Afro-Asian Conference held in the Indonesian city of Bandung in the year 1955. Underline that too. Okay, commonly known as the Bandung Conference, marked the zenith of India's engagement with the newly independent nation and African nation. The Bandung Conference later led to the establishment of NAM. Okay, the first summit of NAM was held at Belgrade in September 1961. Nehru was a co-founder of NAM. Okay, so we already discussed these things there. Just for recapitulation, I told all those things there. So this paragraph is important. Okay, write a short note on Asian African or Afro-Asian unity. Afro-Asian unity. Clear? So no, that's what the last topic we discussed. Next, we are moving towards peace and conflict with China. Peace and conflict with China. Okay, before 4 to 6 months, we read number of news related with the China or Indochina conflicts. Clear? Okay, those conflicts not led to a war, but intense tension between these two countries in the areas of Ladakh, Siachen. Okay, you heard about all those news, right or not? Okay, so Doklam, like that, various ranges are there, areas are there. Okay, so there is intention, tension is existing between India and China on what issue? Territory. Clear or not? Okay, territorial infiltration. That China is always trying to do that. They are trying to infiltrate into the Indian territory. Indian territory. So today's news, maybe you read about, I don't know anyway. Twitter that published a map of India. Okay. Clear or not? Map of India. What is the speciality? What happened there actually? What is the problem with that map?
Kashmir and some parts of Ladakh were excluded.
They are excluded and marked as different countries there, or part of different countries there. So central government is going to take a serious action on Twitter, right? Clear or not? Anyway, whatever the government does or doing, we are not thinking about that. But this kind of activities by foreign organization, it is not permissible, right? Or permissible. We are unable to accept that. Let it be. So, just understand that. So, great applause to Miss Aishwarya. She read the newspaper at least today. Okay. So, good. Okay. So, let it be. So, this is what I want from you people. Okay. We want to update yourself. Want to read the news there. Okay. Want to know what is going on around us. That is very important. Very important. Okay. So, remember. Oops. Newspaper reading is important. Sorry, guys. Coming back. So, peace and conflict with China. Peace and conflict with China. Unlike its relationship with Pakistan, Free India began its relationship with China on a very friendly note. Remember, very friendly note. After Chinese Revolution in 1949. Okay, Chinese Revolution. We got independence in the year 1947, right? Okay. But China started a perfect administrative method, or they following start following a perfect administrative method only after 1949 after the Chinese Revolution. Chinese Revolution, but you heard about Mao Zedong, right? Heard about him, Mao Zedong? No, right. The Long March? No. Okay. So I'm not studied. I think so. Maybe you read from somewhere. There is no such a topics covered so far. Okay. From any textbook, let it be. So that's what. Okay. The Chinese Revolution. Chinese Revolution. Okay. So after that, they created a democratical government in China. In China, there. What kind of democratic government? Single party democracy. Single party democracy. What do you mean by single party democracy? Just give me one moment. Okay, so the question is single party democracy. What is that? Anyone?
There will be only one party, and when held elections, people have to choose different candidates from the same party.
Same party, very good. Okay, so there is no choice for the people. There is no choice for the people. And they will not allow any other party to develop or flourish in that country, right? Clear or not? Okay. So only one party, the candidates from the same party, and there is no choice for the people. Okay, there is no choice for the people because all the candidates' program, policy, and agenda is the same, right? Okay, they are always following the agenda of that political party, that is the Communist Party of China. Okay, Communist Party of China. Clear or not? So Mao Zedong is a person. He always famous for or notorious for weighing decisions there. A decision, sir, sometimes it is good for the country, or sometimes it will create lots of problem. For example, I can say that, okay, he wants to noted that the sparrows are the birds, they are eating almost all the grains that are cultivated in China. Clear? Not almost all, okay. They are consuming more. Clear? The sparrows. Okay. So he declared that to kill all these sparrows. And declared awards or rewards for the people, those who are killing and submitting that dead sparrows to the military, okay, or to the government. Clear or not? And what happened in the next agriculture season, you know? Any idea? All sparrows.
Crops were affected with this pest and...
Definitely, that's what happened in China there. Okay. This more devastating one. Okay, clear or not? Let sparrow eat some grain. It is nothing. Okay, but what happened in the next agriculture season? There is no sparrows as a result of that. The number of pests increased. Okay, clear or not? Insects increased. Okay, as a result of that, they faced the food shortage. Clear? Clear or not? Okay, so we will say in India, it is Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Heard about him? Heard about him, Muhammad bin Tughlaq? No idea about him. Okay, we'll discuss in the next class. Okay, come back. Okay, that's what the Chinese administration at that time. So India was one of the first countries to recognize the communist government. So remember, Nehru, we know that he is a staunch believer of socialism, right? Okay, clear or not? So India is the first country, they accepted the communist government in China, right or not? No other countries. It is India, they first accepted the communist or socialist government in China. Okay, Nehru felt strongly for this neighbor that was coming out of the shadow of Western domination and helped the new government in international forum. Some of his colleagues, like Vallabhai Patel, were worried about a possible Chinese aggression in future. So Nehru supported China because he always thinking about an unity in Asia. Almost all the Asian countries want to unite. That's what the idea of Nehru. Okay, clear or not? So he accepted the newly formed communist government in China and did a possible help for China. Clear on international level. But his colleagues like Sardar Vallabhai Patel, he was always worried about what? A Chinese aggression. Aggression means attack. Clear? A Chinese aggression. Chinese attack. Okay. So we are worried about a possible Chinese aggression in future. But Nehru thought it was exceedingly unlikely. So Nehru thought that there is no chance for it. Okay, that India will face an attack from China for a very long time. The Chinese border was guarded by paramilitary forces, not the army. Clear? Clear or not? So Chinese boundary was guarded or protected not by the army, but by the paramilitary forces. Okay, they don't have the powers of army, the real army, right? Paramilitary. All right. The joint and unification of Panchsheel, the five principles of peaceful coexistence. So underline that. Okay, underline the joint enunciation of Panchsheel, the five principles of peaceful coexistence. Panchsheel. By the Indian Prime Minister Nehru and the Chinese Prime Minister Shao Enlai. Shao Enlai. You can see here, underline Shao Enlai. On 29th April 1954 was a step in a direction of stronger relationship between the two countries. So they signed in an agreement. What is that? What is that? It's termed as Panchsheel. What is that? Panchsheel. These principles to avoid war, okay, avoid war and keep peaceful coexistence, and two prime ministers, okay, they signed in that agreement. Who are they? That's Jawaharlal Nehru and Shao Enlai. So, Malayalis, this is Shao Enlai. This Shao Enlai. Okay, let it be. On 29 April 1954 was a step to direction of strong relationship between the two countries. Indian and Chinese leaders visited each other's country and were greeted by large and friendly crowds. Okay, so both the Indian Prime Minister visited China and the Chinese Prime Minister visited India, and both were greeted with the friendly crowds. Okay, crowds accepted both these leaders. Okay, both these leaders. Nowadays we know that our Prime Minister almost visited a number of countries, right or not? Yeah. Almost all the big crowds accepted him, and they waited for listening. Waited for listening his speech. Clear? Number of countries, the Indian community, even that people from that particular countries too. Okay. Next one. Okay, we will discuss about the Tibet issue later. So come back to the text. Okay, so now it is the Chinese invasion. So there are a number of reasons that are there for the Chinese invasion. Invasion in the sense of attack or trying to control our boundaries. Okay, so okay, no problem. We'll go back to the Tibetan issue. Just understand that what are the reasons for this war or invasion there. Okay, so Tibet. Do you know the geographical location of Tibet? Tibet, geographical location of Tibet, above Nepal, right? Above Nepal. Okay, that region. So the plateau of the Central Asian region called Tibet, underline, is one of the major issues that historically caused tension between India and China. The Tibetan issue is a major issue that created, or today also, okay, it is the thing that creating problems between India and China. From time to time in history, China had claimed administrative control over Tibet. Okay, China wanted to control this region, the Tibetan plateau. Clear? Clear? Okay. And from time to time, Tibet was independent too. Clear? At the same time, Tibet is an independent area. It is, right? Independent area. Clear? But now it is almost controlled by or controlling by China. Okay. China took over control of Tibet. Large sections of the Tibetan population opposed this takeover. Then, China is always speaking about one particular racial theory, right? What is that, you know? Mongoloids. They are mongoloids. Clear? What is special to mongoloids? Mongoloids. So, there are different races in our world, right? You know, I think so, right? So, come back to India. There are some major races are there, like Aryans, Dravidians, Mongoloids, Anglo-Indians. Okay. Clear or not? Like that some races are there. So these races, we are able to find a particular person's race. Okay. By observing his physical features, right? Physical features, right? Okay. So let's think about that one thing. We are Dravidians, right or not? So the complexion of the skin, it is dark brown skin. clear, thick lips will be there, round face structure. Okay, brown iris will be there and black hair. Blacker hair, clear. And short horn people, average height is 5.62. That 5.6 only the average height of males in the Dravidian community or Dravidian race. Okay, so basically South Indians are Dravidians, right? Yes or no? Okay, and hair on the face, that is another characteristics. Clear? Okay, I mean thick hair, not just some hair, thick hair on the face is the other characteristics. I already told you that. So easily we are able to find Dravidian. The Aryans means they are tall horn people there, right? Tall people, clear? Six and above, the Punjabis are example for that. Clear? At the same time, they are fair complexion. Skin is a fair complexion skin. Okay, fair people they are. And long nose, narrow lips, clear? Narrow lips, that's their characteristics. Okay, mangloats means looking like the Chinese people, the Chinese origin they are. Okay, basically from Orissa, a northeastern state, that people is looking like a Chinese people, mangloats. What is that? Uplifted eyebrows, okay, eyes, and pale yellow color skin, okay, protruding jaws, jaws somewhat projected towards, okay, protruding jaws, clear or not, and less hair on the face, that's what their speciality, and what we can say, their nose, we know that, right? Okay, it is not like Dravidians or Aryans, there some specialities there for that nose. So different, the people belong to different races. So Negroes, we know, when today we are not using the term Negroes, okay, it's a special race there, okay, so what is their speciality? Well-built body, but the color, dark complexion skin, okay, curly hair, like that, understand, clear? So the people from Arunachal Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh in India, okay, so China says that it was the part of China because the people is looking like a Chinese people, right? Definitely, right, they can say like that, understand. But what is the specialty of India? India is a land of different culture, diversities, right or not? Not only Mangalotes, Aryans are there, Dravidians are there, Anglo-Indians are there, like that, various groups of people are living in India. That's what our point, understand? Okay, so come back. So in 1950, China took over control of Tibet. Large sections of the Tibetan population opposed this takeover. So the people of Tibet, they are also Mangalotes, clear or not? Clear, they also belong to the same race. So China tried to took over that region, but the people in that particular area, they opposed it. Okay, India tried to pursue China to recognize Tibet's claims for independence. So India decided to support Tibet to get independence, to get independence from China. Is that clear? India supported Tibet. When the Panjshir Agreement was signed between India and China in 1954, okay, through one of its clause about respecting each other's territorial integrity and sovereignty. It was one clause in that particular Panjshir. What is that? Respecting, okay, others' territorial integrity and sovereignty, okay, should not interfere in the internal affairs of China. Okay, India should not interfere in the internal affairs of China, right? At the same time, China will not interfere in the internal affairs and sovereignty or supreme power of the government of India. Clear? That is one point. But India, now what happened? What happened? Just read it here. India considered China's claim over Tibet. The Tibetan spiritual leader Dalai Lama accompanied the Chinese Prime Minister Chiang Kai-shek during the official Chinese visit to India in 1956. He informed Nehru about the worsening situation in Tibet, but China had already assured India that Tibet will be given greater autonomy than enjoyed by any other region of China. Okay, so Dalai Lama is the religious head of Tibet, religious head. Okay, they are Buddhists, clear? And the religion of that region, basically Chinese people, you know that they are a Buddhist, right or not? So Buddhism is a religion that moved from India to China, right? Yes or no? The people, those who believe in Lord Buddha, okay, they are the followers of, or who are the followers of Lord Buddha, are called as Buddhist, right or not? So Buddha is an Indian, he was an Indian king, right? Right or not? Let it be. Okay, so he is the spiritual leader of Tibet, Dalai Lama, and he complained about this particular situation to Indian government, and already the same time, Chiang Kai-shek, the Prime Minister of China, guaranteed to India that they will provide autonomy, greater power for Tibet, administrative powers for Tibet. Sensing that the situation had become worse in 1959, the Dalai Lama crossed over into the Indian border and sought asylum with which was granted. So you can read it again one more time. But the Chinese government guaranteed to India that they will allow autonomy to Tibet. But the problem in Tibet, it is worsened. It became very bad, very bad. Clear or not? The Chinese military tried to attack this Tibetan people to prove their administrative power, all right? Or their control over Tibet. But at the same time, Dalai Lama escaped from China and reached India and asked for asylum. Asylum means what? Protection. Okay, clear or not? So at the same time, Indian government agreed, they provided asylum for Dalai Lama. The Chinese government strongly protested against this. Okay, so Chinese government reacted very badly against this activity of Indian government. Over the last half century, a large number of Tibetans have also sought a refuge in India and many other countries of the world. So, like 50 years, what happened there? Number of people from Tibet, they came to India and went to some other countries. Okay, to escape from these Chinese atrocities. Okay, in India, particularly in Delhi, there is a large settlement of Tibetan refugees. So, if you go to Delhi, we are able to find a large area where these Tibetan people resides. Okay, as refugees. Refugees means, what do you mean by the name refugees?
People who came from another land.
Another land, or the people, those who lost all their wealth, clear or not? Okay, they are living with the support of some other organization or the government, that's called to be refugees. Okay, clear or not? Refugees from Sri Lanka, we know that what the problem they made. Okay, so next one. Dharmasala in Himachal Pradesh is perhaps the largest refugee settlement of Tibetan in India, underline. So, Dharmasala, okay, where we are able to find large settlement of Tibetan people. The Dalai Lama has also made Dharmasala his home in India, underline. In the 1950s and 1960s, many political leaders and parties in India, include the Socialist Party and the Jansang, supported the cause of Tibetan independence. China has created the Tibet Autonomous Region, which is an integral part of China. Tibetan opposed the Chinese claim that Tibet is a part of Chinese territory. They also oppose the policy of bringing into Tibet more and more Chinese settlers. Tibet disputes China's claim that autonomy is granted, okay, to the region. Clear? Clear or not? So this is the basic issue between India and China. So in the Panchsheel, they signed an agreement. What is that agreement? What is the agreement? Can anyone tell me, Sneha? What is the agreement? So, what is that clause? Tell me that clause. So, five principles are there, right? So, what the most important clause in that Panchsheel? Come on, fast, fast. No time for us.
Peaceful coexistence.
Yeah, it is okay, fine. Peaceful coexistence. Okay. But India violated one related with the Tibetan issue. What is that? What is that? Ashirya?
Not to interfere in the internal problems
internal?
Of both the countries.
Internal affairs and sovereignty. Okay, respecting the sovereignty, right. Clear or not? So that's what the principle or a major clause that violated by India. As a result of that, what happened? The Chinese government reacted very badly. Clear. So Elvina, tell me what the Tibetan issue?
Mainly the Chinese wanted to control to control over the Tibet, but the Tibet people took opposed over to this. And and while the India has also interfered in the problems of the Chinese in India.
Okay. So in China, India interfered in that problem, Tibetan issue. Clear or not? Clear or not? Okay. So Dalai Lama, he asked asylum, right or not? Clear or not? Okay, continue.
And India also supported the Tibetan people, and the Chinese also offered that they will give many autonomy. In that, they Chinese military attacked the people in Tibetans, and the Tibetan and the Dalai Lama has come across the India with his followers, and asking for the asylums, and many of the Tibetan people have been in the refuges in India, and little many people had. Many people has been left their country from Tibet to other places, and the Chinese has also
says that they are Tibet is a part of their territory, but the
okay, so last 50 years we know that the number of people from Tibet they moved to some other countries. Okay, now they are the refugees there, right? Refugees. Even in India also there are two settlements are there. What are they, Amaldas? What are the two settlements of Tibetan people in India? Name the places.
Dharamshala.
Then
Delhi.
Okay, correct. Okay, so these ideas are clear or not? So remember, Grishma, turn on your camera. Grishma, is there any trouble with Grishma? Grishma, are you there? Hello. Okay, so this is the problem. This is what the problem. Okay, that created a lot of tension between India and the China, the Indo-China conflicts. Clear? Okay, so come back to the textbook. So the important years are there, just to mark that again. So first of all, the Panchasila that was signed in the year 1954. Okay, next one, another Shavalai, he visited India in the year 1956, related with this Tibetan issue. Underline that. And Dalai Lama report the situation of Tibet is not good. Okay, and he came to India for asylum. That's in the year 1959. Clear? Okay, and Dalai Lama has also made the Dharamsala his home in India. In 1950s and 1960s, many political leaders and parties in India, including the Socialist Party and the Jalsang, support the cause of Tibetan independence. Tibet's independence. That is clear? Okay, so Panchasila, that's a very important point. The name of the Chinese Prime Minister, it is important point. The place where the Tibetan settlement in India, that also important. Clear? Okay, so now the ideas are related with the Tibetan issue is clear for you people. Okay, so the first invasion of China, that's in the year 1962. Clear? 1962. Underline that. So two developments find this relationship with China, annexed the Tibet in the year 1950, and thus removed a historical buffer between the two countries. Clear? Understand? So what is the reason behind that? Why China tried to control this Tibet? What is the reason? Or what was that? Tell me. Amal? Amal, you are drowsy, right? Want to sleep sometime? Huh? No. Tell me. I told you about a racial issue. Tell me that. Amal Raj?
Yes, sir.
Come on, tell me the answer. Why China has tried to control this Tibetan region? What is the point? No idea. That related with any race or something? Any relation with the race?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me. I told that. What the term we will use express the Chinese people? What is their race? If you don't know, please write on Mangaloid. I told you, right? Mangaloid, right. Okay. So, but as more information came about the suppression of Tibetan culture, the Indian government grew uneasy. The Tibetan spiritual leader, the Dalai Lama, okay, so to obtain political asylum in India in the year 1959, so we discussed already, China alleged that the government of India was allowed to anti-China activities to take place from within India. Clear? China alleged that the government of India was allowed anti-China activities to take place from within India. So the Chinese government, so you know that the Chinese government related with all these conflicts, they will come with a number of theories. Clear or not? Huh? So you already know about the COVID-19 and the theories that published by Chinese government. Clear? Okay. No country in the world will believe, or they are not ready to believe these Chinese theories. Chinese theories there. Why? What is the reason behind that? Right, what is the reason behind that? Any idea? So you already discussed about the economical domination of China over the third world countries, right? Economical domination. They allowed or they provided number of or different types of loans to these third world countries, right? Clear or not? Now almost all these countries are in debt trap because the international economic or economy or economical system is almost collapsed. There is no money with the people. There is no money with the governments because of this disease. Clear? Okay. So we can connect all these things, these theories there, right? China is the country. They created this virus and this spread all these things into the entire world. Okay. Entire world economy is declined. Okay. No government is able to pay back the money to the Chinese government. So lots of problem. Now China, they are able to control these third world countries. Clear or not? And they are able to make a new, what is that? Power block. Yes or no? Are you agreeing with this theory or not? It's not my theory, right? As published in different magazines and newspapers, right? Yes or no? That's what. So time memorial, we can say that nobody is basically, they will not believe this Chinese theory is there. Okay. So China, we know that China is the permanent member in the Security Council of UNO, right? And India is the country. They supported this Chinese position or Chinese place in that particular organization called the UNO. Right. Okay. So more back. So I'm just reading only. So already you wrote the notes there. Okay. Please check that. Checking that. A little earlier, a boundary dispute had surfaced between India and China. India claimed that the boundary was a matter settled in a colonial time. Colonial time. Okay. So what is the name of the boundary line between India and China? Boundary line between India and China. Okay, write down. Write down. I will say two lines. Okay. One is McMahon line. McMahon line. McMahon line. The another one is Radcliffe line. Radcliffe line. Radcliffe line, right? So one line separate India and China, the other one separate India and Pakistan. Okay, clear. So you want to find out, underline that. Clear. Two lines are there. One is McMahon line, the other one is a Radcliffe line, in which one of these separate India and Pakistan, and another one separate India and China. Okay, so these lines basically created at the time of the British rule in India, the time of the colonial rule. Colonial rule. Okay, but China said that any colonial decision did not apply. So China, what is their demand now? They are not ready to agree this colonial division. Clear? Understand? So colonialism completed. Now why you are following this colonial division? That's what the question of China. The main disputes was about the western and eastern end of the long border. China claimed two areas within the Indian territory, Aksai Chin area and Ladakh region of Jammu Kashmir. Okay, so China, they claimed two of these areas are Chinese region, it seems. What are they? Aksai Chin area and Ladakh of Jammu Kashmir and much of the state of Arunachal Pradesh in what was then called Northeastern Frontier Agency, NEFA. So this happened between 1957 and 1959. The Chinese occupied the Aksai Chin area and built a strategic road there. Despite a very long correspondence and discussion among top leaders, these differences could not be resolved. Several small borders, skirmishes between the armies of two countries took place. Okay, clear. Okay, want to explain that? No need, right? So China, they demanded these regions. What are they? Aksai Chin, Ladakh, Arunachal Pradesh, that are known as the Northeastern Frontier Agency. Okay, Clear or not? In between the years 1957 and 57 and 59. Okay. Next one. Always there is intense tension between India and Indian and Chinese armies in the border region. Border region. Clear. That's what the end here. Next one. Do you remember the Cuban Missile Crisis in Chapter 1 for the contemporary world politics? Remembering that? The Cuban Missile Crisis? Okay. So, while the entire world's attention was on this crisis involving two superpowers, China launched a swift and massive invasion in October 1962 on both and disputed region. So, entire world is thinking or they're discussing about this Cuban Missile Crisis of 1962, and that time what China did here? China did here? They started an invasion. They had started attacking India. The first attack lasted 1 week and the Chinese force captured some key areas of Arunachal Pradesh. The first war, okay, so nearly 1 week. So the Chinese military captured some important regions in Arunachal Pradesh. The second wave of attack came next month while the Indian forces could block the Chinese advances on the western front of Ladakh. So India defended. Okay, in the eastern, Chinese managed to advance nearly to the entry point of Assam Plains. Finally, China declared a unilateral ceasefire, stop fire, and its troops withdrew to where they were before the invasion began. Okay, clear or not? So they attacked and made some regions under their control. Okay, but finally, they reached the entry point of Assam Plains, means almost the central part of Assam. Finally, what China declared a unilateral ceasefire, they stopped the war and moved back to the region. Again, clear on where from they started the invasion. The China war dictated India's image at home and abroad. India had to approach the Americans and the British for military assistance to tide over the crisis. Clear? India faced a lot of problem at that time and asked help to whom? America and Britain. The Soviet Union remained neutral during the conflict. Why Soviet Union remained neutral? What is the reason? So basically, we know that Jawaharlal Nehru and International Congress Party had a great relation with Russia and USSR. Sorry, USSR. Okay, at that time. Clear. But at the time of Indo-China war, okay, Russia took or USA took a neutral position. Why it is so?
China was before an alliance of the USSR.
Basically, both these countries following the same system of economy and administration, right? Socialism and communism. So, China. Okay. So, India, they started seeking help from USA and Britain. It indeed a sense of national humiliation and at the same time strengthen the spirit of nationalism. Okay, so this Chinese invasion became a humiliation. India felt that it's a humiliation. They treated us very badly. Clear or not? So Panjshir, we always try to create a peace with China, not ready to start a war against China. Okay. But the China attacked India. Okay, some of the top army commanders either resigned or were retired. So, army commanders also resigned from their position. Okay, because they treated very badly. Well, maybe by the government or the politicians. Okay, like that. Nehru's close associate and the defense minister, V. Krishna Menon, he was a Malayali, had to leave the cabinet. So, Krishna Menon resigned. Nehru on stature suffered as his way. Sorry, he was severely criticized for his naive assessment of the Chinese intention and the lack of military preparations here. Okay. So clear. Understanding or not? So Nehru was criticized by his colleagues. Okay. So Nehru always made a friendship with the neighbors. And he created the Panjshir, signed in the Panjshir, and he thought that there is no attack or aggression from China. Okay, so we will discuss in next class. The time up here, 9:21 now. Okay, so we will meet in next class. We'll discuss this paragraph one more time. Okay.